What do you think, Q? Is anyone gonna show up today? I don't think anyone will, because we are very late.
Yeah, we're two and a half hours late, Kiwi.
It's probably your fault. I think it's your fault. Let's pop up.
Very late.
Ah.
Yeah, we're 2 hours.
Let's pop this puppy out. How do I pop it out? No. Pop out. Okay. Got that. And we pop this one out. Okay, Herman blah. He won. He's first. Okay, now let's see. CD documents random coding, and we will make a new library. Okay, let's see. React D3, does that exist already? Of course it does. Okay. Beautiful data-driven animations, that's cool. Obviously, @VX is the winner in this space, I think. But I just want to contribute my own. Cool. Oh, that's new. Seems to be getting used a lot. Okay. React D3 doesn't seem to be very... what's it called? Very used anymore. Oh, really? Did Shirley build that? No. Let's see. Who built this? npm install React D3 github.com repository. Ah, this person did it. Okay, this one looks cool. Let's see. More examples, simple. Oh, that's cool. Very nice. Okay, SVG charts, that's neat. I don't think I can compete with these things, damn. My implementation was actually front-end JavaScript. It wasn't using Node.js. And I'm gonna be working more on that this week, I think. Morgan's going away again, so we're gonna be live coding every evening, working on that, because I have some ideas for what kind of projects I want to build with it. So that should be fun. But first I want to make this today. I'm just trying to figure out what to name it. Okay. So, let's call it... Ooh, Uber also has a library. Okay. So we're gonna call our library unopinionated React D3. Simple React D3. Basic React D3. Let's go with simple React D3 or basic React D3. Simple. Although it would be cool if it also worked with Preact and stuff. Declarative D3. Okay, let's go with simple React D3. Or... Although, because it would be really cool, this the approach I'm working on should work with Preact and all the others as well. So it would be cool if we could make it work with all of them. Yeah, let's start with simple React D3 for now. Git status. Let's go to GitHub and click create. Actually, I'm gonna use NWB here, NWB help, and we are going to, what are we making? NWB create. Okay, new project type, React component. Okay, NWB new React component, simple React D3. Do you want to create an ES6 modules build for use by ES6 bundlers? Yes. Do you want to create a UMD build for global usage? 9. Okay, cool. So cd simple React D3, git status. If I do yarn start, it should start the demo app. Let's see. There's a lot of sun coming from out there, so I can barely see my screen, but we go to localhost 3000. Yay, it's there. Awesome. Welcome to React components. Perfect. So we're going to say git init, git status, git log, Oh, initial commit, perfect, okay. So now we have to create a new repository here and say simple React D3. Simplest React D3, simple React D3 library that never gets in your way. Based on lessons from simple React D3 library that never gets in your way. That's good enough. And we are going to create that repository. Copy git remote add origin blah git push origin master minus u. And we have that thing here now. Wonderful. Now I can say React D3.js. React D3.js. And we can deal with that later. Done. And we go create new file and call it license. And we choose the MIT license. Blup. Sure. Commit. Oh. I should have clicked commit directly to master. Silly me. Come on, merge. Hello, bird. Yeah, we're using this camera today, Kiwi. So if you're trying to look pretty for the camera, you have to orient yourself for that one. Git pull origin master. Wonderful. Now, what do we need? LS source, LS tests. Wonderful. So it would be a good idea to have some tests for this, but I'm going to first build it. Random coding, simple React D3. Let's see, what do tests look like? Index test. And we can open. What? Come on, open the project. Ah, wonderful. So source index.js, and we also open index test. And let's see. Okay, we are going to have to add D3 as a dependency. So we say yarn. Should I also add a prettier RC? Yes. Let's see if I have that in my other repository. React lazy load. Prettier RC. What does it say? Yep. So I'm gonna copy that to here. This makes sure that if anyone decides to contribute to my code, they are automatically going to have the right formatting and stuff. Okay, got that. Git status, git add dot, git commit minus m, add prettier rc. Then we say yarn add D3, which I think is now going to be V5, not V4 anymore. But we shall see. Wow. Let's see if anyone is watching today. Hello, Yoshiki. Ba-ba-ba. Interesting.
The internet's not... Dude, you can't have that many pellets in your mouth.
That's so funny. It says nobody is watching. Ah, there we go. Four people are watching. That's very nice of you guys. Mm-hmm. Okay. Still installing. Not sure why it takes that long, but so okay. So we got this. So I installed D3. Now what we need are demos and yes, and a, let's see, demo source index.js, simple React D3 demo, and our example. What? How does the demo work? Ah, it just imports. Okay, so what we need, what I want to provide in this library are two higher order components. One is D3 black box, and another one is like a component for, I'll show you. So I'm just playing music. Let's see. Oh, no, I don't have that one. Okay. Cool. So in my index.js here, we're going to have two exports. So we are going to export, import D3, export D3 black box from /D3 black box. Does that work? No. Export default from I don't know actually how re-exports work. I always forget that. ES6 re-export. Okay, so we say import D3 black box from D3 black box, and we say export D3 black box.
Yeah, Kiwi.
And we are going to build the D3 black box by copying it from somewhere else. And we should actually call it an SVG black box. Integrating black box components, the Hawk version, and this is going to be an SVG black box. SVG black box, SVG black box. Touch source SVG black box.js. And we open it, and this is going to need all this stuff. Come on. Like that. and this is SVG render. We call SVG render on this context, and we render an anchor element. Wonderful. Why isn't this working? Why is my computer so slow today? Google Chrome Helper is taking up 200 CPUs. What if I kill that? Aha, okay. Cool, so we also have an example already built. We'll be able to just use that. Now we go to our demo. We basically have the SVG black box built now. So we can go into the demo and we can say import SVG black box from .slash source like that. And here we are going to render it. Let's see. Okay, so now it's just the demo. And to make the demo prettier, okay, let's see. Git status. Oh, and let's write a test. Let's see if I can write a test for this. I am very new to testing, or rather, I used to do testing many years ago, and now I'm new to it again. So what is this using? So node before each, node create element, unmount component at node, render component. So if we say SVG black box from source, and we say this should actually be the SVG black box test. So we say move test index test to tests SVG black box minus test JS. We open that. No, that's SVG black box. Where's the tests? SVG black box test. Import expect, import react, import renders, and blah blah blah. SVG black box, we create an element of SVG, unmount component, and we render SVG black box as a node. And let's see, what should this be rendering? Oh, it should actually get, and it should be called SVG black box here as well. So SVG black box is a hawk that renders shit. What's up? So we should expect node. Okay, let's see. Console log node, just to see what's even there. Or rather, we want this. Const component describe SVG black box. It renders anchor element. So we say the component is SVG black box of a function with an empty function. That empty function doesn't have to do anything. Why is Prettier complaining? Okay. And we render component into the node and we console log the node. So now if I run yarn test, I can stop that. I should be able to see what happens. We also need to give it an X and a Y. Or rather, SVG black box should work like that. So by default, they should be 0. Okay, SVG G transform, translate. Okay, so we expect DOM node has child. Or contains. Or rather, DOM find children by element, by tag. Okay, expect node dot get elements by tag name g dot length. To equal 1. Let's see if that test passes. Yay, the test passed. Okay. It renders anchor element, positions anchor element at 0, 0 by default. It positions anchor at XY. It also needs to it uses render method, uses given render method. Okay, so let's try if this works. Before each, let's also say component like that. And this is going to make our lives easier because we can move this into the before each. And we're going to say the SVG black box is going to render. Yes, Kiwi. What is it going to render? Let's say we use the axis example. Prettier, why are you complaining? Oh, this is why. Why are you still complaining, Prettier? Because this needs to be a fat arrow. Okay, so now we have, this is an axis, so we can call it an axis actually. Axis, and we can say import asterisk as d3 from d3, and here we render an axis. In this one we're also going to render an axis, except now how do I get attributes for something? DOM get node attribute, and we say here, let x is equal, here it's fine like this. Now we're going to need element get attribute, perfect. So we're going to say, let attribute equal all of that. The first one, get attribute. Okay, get attribute, and we said it's called the transform attribute. And we're going to expect attribute to equal translate 0, 0. Let's see if that works. In the black box component. Wait, but this just worked right before, didn't it? We just had this working and now suddenly it's not working anymore. It was rendering the element this ref's anchor. Okay, what if I do it this way? Does it work then? Interesting. Hi. It's now not working because we are running in a funny environment. So this D3 select thing that we have here, it doesn't work in a test environment. It only works in an actual browser. So that's a funny problem. But let's solve these first. See if that works. So this needs to look like that. Ow, bird, no, don't bite me. Now I copy this again, and we pass in axis as x 10, y equals 20. And now we expect this to be 10, 20. Perfect. Now I'm going to add a, because we can't get this to work in Phantom.js, I'm just gonna make sure that it gets called. Because if it gets called, then it's fine. So I need a sign-on thing for that, right? Sign-on. We need a spy. Wonderful. Let's see. Yarn add sign on. Okay, I'll be right back.
Okay. I am back. Let's see.
So SVG black box looks like this. It's a relatively simple higher order component, but I want to expand it a little bit so that it can also work as getting render props instead of just the hawk pattern, because I think that's going to make it easier for some people to use. Now let's make this spy. So we do that and we say let axis be SVG black box that takes assign on dot spy, or rather let my render be assign on spy, and we say we pass in my render and we say render axis into node we should expect my render to be how do I use this with the expect library? Expect library sign on. Interesting. Okay, so it doesn't. We can just create a spy from expect. Interesting. Okay, yarn remove sign on, because we don't need it apparently. We have expect, and we can take create spy from expect, and we. How do I use create spy? So we say spy is create spy, and we put the spy there. So how do I use a spy? We expect spy to be called expect spy calls length, wow, expect spy dot calls dot length to equal 1, and we should also say this is easier. We expect spy to have been called. And we want the context to be what do we want the context to be? All right, let's see if that works. Yarn test. Okay, so I can now also fix this and say function so that way it's going to actually work. Let's see. Although that's really annoying because almost everybody uses fat arrow functions these days. Ah, no, it still doesn't work. Yeah, I think the reason... I think the actual reason it doesn't work is because of this D3 select. See, if I take that out, then it works. So it's D3 select doesn't work with in the test environment, because if I console log this ref's anchor, it's going to not be working.
Yeah.
Let's see. Yeah, and it is actually called anchor. See, it renders the anchor. But when I try to select it, it doesn't work because it's complaining that the G tag doesn't work. Because Phantom.js doesn't have support for... what is it? Phantom.js SVG support. Anyway, I think this is the reason D3 select isn't working. Error, warning, tag G is unrecognized. Let's see, Phantom.js, and I think Phantom.js is actually no longer supported anyway. So whatever the CLI I'm using that set up all the tests and stuff is getting kind of out of date. Yeah. Okay. So I am going to make this function not do anything. Like that, and we can say that the basic SVG black box is built. I'm also going to say vim git ignore, and I am going to add yarn error dot log. What was it? Yarn error dot log. We don't want that one. Git add dot, and we say git commit minus a minus m basic SVG black box hawk. Cool. Now let's see if it works. Let's make it work with render props as well. Let's see. It uses render prop. Now this, let's see if this is going to work. We say let spy equals create spy, and we say let axis equal, or rather we're just going to do it this way, render svg black box. Hopefully this is going to work, we'll see. And we're going to say render is a is our spy. So that should work. And it should render into node. And then do this stuff. And we should expect our spy to have been called. Ah. Git log. And we reset back because I did not mean to paste that. And we run yarn test. Let's see. Running tests. Spy was not called. Perfect. So we go into SVG black box. And over here, when we're rendering, we say render can be this props. So we are going to render that, or rather, not there. In component did update and component did mount, we're going to say we're going to call our render function this.render, and here we're going to say this.underscore render, and underscore render is going to be a function that calls SVG render if it exists. If how do I check if something is a function? JavaScript check if function. Okay. So we're going to say if SVG render exists for now. We really should make sure that it's a function, shouldn't we? Let's see. Can I install just lodash is function? lodash.com yarn add, let's see, npmjs is function. Okay, yarn add lodash dot is function. That's going to be easiest. And we say import is function from lodash dot is function. If is function svg render then we call it, like that, else if is function so const render and children from props. We take render and children from props. If is function render, then we call render with this refs anchor. So this would give us the option to render into the thing. And else if is function children, we're gonna also support that. We're going to say children get the ref. Okay, now let's run the test. Yarn test. Let's see if that works. Okay. So it does not use render props. That's unfortunate. So let's see. Let's see if it even gets props. It should be getting props. So here, let's see. Console log. Hi, this dot props. And SVG black box test. So render spy. How do I run just a specific test? We're using, I think, the karma runner. Let's see. Package JSON. Yarn test is NWB test react. No idea how that works. But I know it's using karma. So karma run specific test. Or maybe we're using... I don't even know what we're using, man. Yeah, let's try that. Yarn test minus 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 grep equals render props. Let's see if that works. Hey, that worked. No, it did not work. Oh well. I have no idea how to make that work, but let's see. Hi object. Okay, so it only uses render props. Now I can run that, and I yarn test, and I think the problem is that we are using SVG black box directly instead of using it as a hawk. So how do I make something that's useful both directly and as a hawk? Let's see. What do we actually get as our thing? Console log arguments. So I'm gonna see, now I'm trying to see when React calls SVG black box. It needs to immediately go into this instead of returning a class, I think. Or rather, it needs to somehow pass props down. Let's see if we get props. Okay, so we do get the render function. Wonderful. How do I pass props into it? Okay, if is function SVG render, or if is object. How do I check if it's an object? Let's see. Low dash dot is object. Does that exist? Yes. Okay, so we say yarn add low dash dot is object, and we're going to import is object from low dash dot is object, and I'm going to say if is object of our SVG render then we want to say so we say let render and children or rather down here. So if is function svg render else if like this object dot so what I want to do is I want to get props from I want to get render and children either from svg render or from props if they were passed in that way, because that will give us the most flexibility. So I want to say object dot assign svg render this props, and that gets split into things, but we only want to do this if svg render is not a function. So we say if is object svg render, then we take svg render, otherwise we take an empty object for this assignment, and now it should work. Yarn test, and here we can delete this because I think it's just gonna work. So let's see. Spy was still not called. So let's see. Console log svg render render and children. Let's see, what does that give us? It's hard to, maybe I'm trying to be too flexible here. Where is my console log even? Console log. Render a bunch of those. Let's see. Wait, is it not even getting in here? Ah, of course it isn't. Okay, so this is not working. Which means we can remove all this stuff and go back to doing svg render call on this. Yeah. And we're gonna have to take a slightly different approach. Here we're going to say if is function svg render, we say return black box, like that. So we take this. Or rather, let's just put that here. So we return, if it's a function, so if svg render is a function, then we return a hawk, else if svg, if it's an object, svg render, then we return what? then this needs to be, this is terrible. How do I make something work both as a higher order component and as a normal component directly? Because right now it's just a functional stateless component, but I need life cycles. Does anyone have an idea how to do this? Because I'm getting getting kind of stumped. Let's see if the internet knows. Component that works as hawk and as direct component. Same component as higher order component and render props. Yeah, okay. Okay. Aha. Okay. So here we have a way of doing this. I'm going to undo everything. Come on, undo. Okay, we don't poop there.
We're supposed to poop here.
Still undoing. Okay. Now let's see. So we're now exporting SVG black box. And but if I export it like this, so I can also do export const SVG black box. It needs to have a different name, but it can take children and render and other props and pass in children of props or rather let's do it this way. If children, then it returns, or rather, oh, I know, like this. Children, if it exists, otherwise it takes render of props. And that should work in theory. But it needs to have a different name, otherwise things are going to get weird. Hi. Rather, I can do it this way. You can say SVG black box hawk is that, and we take SVG render, and we say if is object SVG render. Right, that's gonna work. If is object SVG render, we say this const children equals SVG render, and we return this thing, return that's if it's an object. Else, it's we assume that it's a function, so we can say else if is function SVG render. In that case, we return SVG black box hawk called on SVG render, like that. Right? Let's see if that works. Export default SVG black box. No. Do not wrap that. Export default SVG black box yarn test. Let's see if that works. High hopes. Import is object from low-is object, and import is function from low-is function. Run. Okay. Undefined is not a constructor evaluating render of props. Okay, so let's see. Because here we're just passing in a function directly. So that should be. Okay, let's see. Index SVG black box. Let's see what we're getting. Ah. Okay. Console log of SVG render. Arg. So let's see what that is. What does it get us? Yes. So it literally tells us that it's a function is object SVG render and is function SVG render. Why is that not working correctly? Well, the weird thing right now is that, hi Kiwi, is that this is saying that what's passed in is both a function and a, hi, and so is function and is object, they're both returning true, which is what's causing the problem. Why is that happening? Let's see. How does Lodash implement this? Hi, Burb. Lodash? How is it doing this? Is object and is object like, what is that, is function. Ah, right, so we have to check that it's a function first and then check that it's an object. Or we can use isObjectLike. How does that work? Let's see. Lodash isObjectLike. Okay, no. So I need to swap these two around and then it's going to work. If is function, otherwise we just attempt this. Like that. So if it's a function, we return all of that stuff. If it's not a function, we try to do it as render props. But if neither children nor render are defined, then it's just going to error out. There's not much I can do about that. Let's see if that works. Aha, nothing was returned. Wonderful. Why was nothing returned? Let's see, did we get to here? Console log, hi. And let's see if we get children render and what the SVG render is. So I think this is progress. We're getting a different error. Hi, Kiwi. So we do get to high, and we children is undefined, which is expected. Render is defined and it's a function. So what we have to actually return is our normal this thing. Because if we just call the function, it's not actually returning anything. So how do we do that? Okay, we're going to say return x and y. Oh, and here we can also say we can pass in other props here. Props. So it works as a hawk. Now I need to make it work. Let's see. So we take the transform function and we say translate x and y normally. And then inside we are calling these things. What's wrong? This needs to be closed. Why is Prettier complaining? Ah, like that. And here we say this goes like that. But here, when we are rendering them, we need to give them a reference to the grouping element. How do I do that? Because now we have just, problem is that we now have just a functional component, and if we want to pass a reference in, it's going to be difficult. Hi, Kiwi. So I'm not sure this is even possible to make work with render props. Hi. Pass ref react pass ref to rep pass ref to child. Interesting. Hi, Burb. Let's see. Let anchor be an empty thing. And let's try a ref callback. Takes a node and says anchor equals node, which is kind of terrible, but we can then pass anchor into our children. Let's see if that works. Okay, so that worked. We're gonna have to still confirm that it actually works, but it passes our test. So it can use a render prop. It can uses function as children, which is going to look like this. Anchor into spy. Rather, let's just call it a spy. SVG black box. Let's see. I think all the tests are gonna pass now, but I still have to actually write the demo to make sure that this works in practice. Cool. Git commit -a -m make SVG. Black box support render props. Okay, now let's go into our demo app and make sure that this actually works. So here we have, okay, simple React D3 demo, and I'm going to render a small SVG with a width of 600 and a height, let's do width of 300 and a height of 200, like that. And we are going to render an SVG black box that is at 00, and it does all of this. So we're going to take that and we're going to import asterisk as D3 from D3. And I'm going to use my, my axis example to see if this works. So, like this. And we say yarn start, and we cross our fingers and hope for the best. So it's compiling. Export SVG black box was not found. We have to do it this way. No. So we go to index source and we say import SVG black box from SVG black box. Export default SVG black box. And here. Why is that not working? Okay, then let's do it this way. SVG black box. Will that make it work? Not sure why that's not working. Okay. From dot dot slash source What? So demo source. Ah. That's why. Okay. We import SVG black box from ../... source slash. No, just that. ../... source yarn start. And now it should work. Cool. Now let's see if it actually works. 9. Okay. Because we need to go into our SVG black box component and have to say that X is 0 by default and Y is also 0 by default. Hmm. That did not quite work. Let's see. Is it even rendering? SVG black box has a reference. It's a good sign. So we have the SVG, we have the reference, but nothing renders into the reference.
Which is a problem, isn't it, Kiwi?
Let's make sure that the basics work first. So if I go into our index.js demo, I can here make a axis component. We're gonna try this first. And we're going to say here axis at x equals 10 and y equals 10. So we're now gonna see at least the basics should work, not the render props. D3 black box is not defined because it is called an SVG black box, like that. Okay, so that works. The basic hawk approach works, but this approach does not work. Does our function get called? Console.log, hello there. And what is the anchor that is passed in? Hello there, an anchor is undefined. That's our problem.
Kiwi, relax. Yes, Kiwi.
I know what we can do.
Kiwi, hi.
We can do something very, very dirty. We can say window request animation frame and then call this thing. See, now it worked. Now we just have to make sure. This feels terrible, and I think this is something that's going to stop working with React 16.3, but let's see. We go to SVG black box. Oh, and now let's see if my tests actually still pass. I think we just broke tests, but the demo app. And here we have to select the anchor, and now it should work. Now we should get two axes, and we do. Aha! We say x is this 30, or let's do 50. Nice. I feel very dirty for having done that, but it works. Git commit -a -m prove with demo that hawk and render prop approach works. Wonderful. Okay, I'm gonna save this image. Black box hawk render prop. And let's see. Okay. And I think I'm gonna stop. How long have I been live coding? An hour and a half. Yeah, that's my usual hour and a half. I'm gonna stop. Yes. I'm gonna stop live coding now, and we'll be back working on this same stuff.
Hi. Yes. 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 I know you want to chat.
We're gonna be back probably tomorrow night. I'm gonna have a chance to live code every night this week, so I'm gonna try to live code this tomorrow around 9 p.m. Pacific. Actually, maybe not, maybe 10 p.m. Pacific, but tomorrow night we're going to continue on this and finish this library, because I think this is a promising approach for something that other libraries don't support yet. And it's also going to be something I'm going to add to the React in D3 book. So thanks everyone for watching, and I will see you tomorrow.